In today's video, we're going to be taking a look at this very cool USB plasma ball. This one I picked up, it was on sale at my local restore. It was in a clearance section, it was $1.99, and it was brand new. You do get a very nice display from this one. You can plug it into the USB port on your computer, or you can use the USB charger for your cell phone. These do retail around $12 to $15. But if you like what you see here, I did find it for $8 shipped on one website, and I will place the link to that website in the video description area. Okay, let's open this up and check it out. This is what it looks like once it's unboxed. You have your on-off power switch. Over here is the power supply heading off to your USB charger for your phone, or it could be plugged directly into your laptop. These plasma balls are the creation of Nikola Tesla. The plasma ball is similar to a Tesla coil, but they're not quite the same. The Tesla coil has a primary and secondary winding. The secondary winding has many turns of enamel wire that would be wrapping around that centerpiece inside the plasma ball. And at the top, you would have a metal electrode where the sparks would be shooting off of. This one here is different. There is no secondary winding. You have just a high voltage tip inside that globe, and there's enough voltage produced in order to ionize the gas inside the plasma ball. Inside that glass sphere is a noble gas. Now, noble gases are generally neon, argon, krypton, or xenon. When you have the high voltage within the sphere, the gases ionize from the high voltage electricity, causing them to glow. When those gases are glowing, they are conducting electricity. There are a couple of things I'd like to show you, so let me get started by first turning the lights down and powering up the unit. Now that it's on, you can see the very cool pattern it puts out. When I touch the glass with my hand, you will not feel any shocks because you have the insulating layer of glass. I am grounded, so it's going to be attracted to my body. And it does feel very warm in my hand. Now I'm going to take a small neon lamp, like you see right here. I'm going to hold it in close proximity to the globe to demonstrate that the electric field coming off of the plasma globe extends out much further than you see right here. Here we go. Coming in from the left. And it's on all the way over there. Brighter and brighter. Still on over there. Coming from the right side. And it's on again right there. Pretty cool. Right around there. Now if I take a metal object and I place it nearby the plasma globe, what will happen, instead of the neon lamp coming on at this spot right here, it'll come on much, much further away because the plasma ball is going to be putting a charge on the metal object, allowing me to get this to light up at a further distance. Let me place this drink can right there. All right. This should come on a little further to the right. All right, so you can see it's more to the right side. Before it was in that area. And look at how bright when I actually... See, no matter what I do, it's one brightness. It's one brightness no matter what I do. I can touch it with both fingers, it's one brightness. Now watch when I touch the can, which has that charge on it. Look how bright that is. Very, very bright. Almost like being plugged into the AC socket. That's what it looks like without touching the can. And when you touch the can, very bright. Very, very cool. Now I want to show you something else. You could touch this all you want. All right, because of that layer of glass, you're not going to feel any shock. But if you place a sheet of aluminum foil over the top of the globe, it's going to end up acting like a capacitor. Capacitors are nothing more than two plates, very, very close together, but not touching. So what we're going to have is a dielectric material, just like what's inside of a capacitor, between those two plates. That's going to be the glass, and then the aluminum foil on top is going to be one of the plates that's going to accumulate the charge. When I do that, you definitely do not want to touch that aluminum foil because you will get a shock. Once the aluminum is in position, once I do that, I'm going to take the alligator clip, hold it very, very close to the aluminum foil, and you're going to see a spark jumping between the foil and the grounded alligator clip. Before I do that, though, I'm going to hold the alligator clip against the glass to show you that there will not be any spark jumping between the glass and the alligator clip. Okay, my alligator clip is grounded to a cold water pipe. Let me hold it very close. You can see it being attracted to it. Let me go right against the glass. Now I'm going to pull away very easy. And as you can observe, I'll hold it lower, it's darker so you can see it. There's no arc coming off that glass to the tip of the alligator clip. Now let me put on the aluminum foil top and repeat the test. The aluminum foil is now in position on top of the plasma ball. I'm going to be turning it on. You will hear a little bit of a change in the sound of the plasma ball, but what you're going to want to do is watch very carefully between the tip of the alligator clip and the aluminum foil. This time you'll see a spark jumping between the foil and the clip. Here we go. And there you have it. It charged up just like a capacitor's plates. Now let's take this apart and take a look at the inside. Okay, it's been disassembled and you can see this nipple sticking up. That's where the gas was placed inside the globe and then sealed off. If you look at the outside, the end, which looks like the bottom of a test tube, that is aluminized on the inside. And you can see there's very fine turnings of aluminum packed into that end. This wire loom was inserted in there next. And you have this high voltage wire, which is red. It slides all the way inside the wire loom until the end of the wire makes contact with the shavings inside the tip. The high voltage generator, which is this board, is very simple. It's just a step-up transformer. Many turns of fine wire on the secondary and fewer turns of heavier gauge wire on the primary. In order to drive the transformer using 5 volts DC, the transistor here creates pulses into the primary, and then you have your pulse DC output coming off this lead. If you enjoyed this video, please rate it a thumbs up, subscribe, and post links to this video on other websites and blogs. Also, be sure to check out my video playlist as well. Thank you very much for watching.